creativity. And I wanted to suggest that one of the most important and meaningful ways that you could use creativity in your life is by designing and mapping out your journey so that it reflects who you are and what's truly important to you. And I'm going to give you an example by showing you my journey and how I was able to reinvent myself several times, really, from who I was to what I wanted to become. Like the Baudelaire orphans in Lemony Snicket's series of unfortunate events, my life had a bad beginning. My parents escaped the communist revolution in China, and they brought everything that they could carry in a few suitcases. They didn't speak English, we were impoverished, and we ended up living on the Lower East Side. Now today, the Lower East Side is one of the hippest and trendiest neighborhoods of New York. But it wasn't back then, it was a slum. Our home was a rat and cockroach infested apartment. And I was surrounded by squalor. School wasn't much better. This is my elementary school. I had a kindergarten teacher who used to lock me up in a closet because I didn't speak English. And I didn't want to end up locked in a closet forever. So I knew I had to change my life. I realized that education would be my ticket to the life that I wanted. So I studied really hard, and I won a full scholarship to a prep school in Midtown Manhattan. And there, I was exposed to a dazzling world full of culture and beauty, and it was wonderful. I had amazing teachers from all over the world. And we took field trips to countless museums, plays, ballets, and other live performances. So at 17, I created a bucket list of what I wanted for my future. College, an exciting career, and travel, especially to Japan and France. When I went to college, it was so different than today. We went to college to find out who we were and to discover what we wanted to be. You had 4 years to figure out what you wanted to do with the rest of your life. So I studied subjects that I was truly passionate about, and I ended up majoring in East Asian Studies, focusing on art history and religion. I spent my junior year in Tokyo, and there I learned how to throw pottery, and I meditated with monks in monasteries. My senior year, one of my professors in religion asked me to set a mood in his Buddhism lectures. So I started experimenting and producing multimedia presentations, matching slides and music. And I loved doing it. It actually gave me an idea of what I might want to do in life. I became a broadcast journalist. This is the newsroom at Eyewitness News in Los Angeles. Because I believed that by doing that, I could somehow change the world. I loved working in TV, especially being part of a crew. I moved to 4 different cities on both coasts to advance my career. And along the way, I had some amazing opportunities, like working with Oprah Winfrey and her best friend, Gail King, for 3 years. She used to call me Chin Chin, because Chin is my maiden name. And also got to write for one of my heroes, the late and great Charles Kuralt. I moved to Los Angeles to become a writer on the show Entertainment Tonight, and I made the transition from local news to entertainment news, and for the next 10 years, I covered all the award shows, the Oscars, the Emmys, the Grammys, and all of the movies and music that are released every year. Working in TV is a constant adrenaline rush. You are always on deadline, and you're constantly on call. The work is grueling, but the pay is pretty good. But you have to commit to working 60 to 80 hours if you choose to be in this field and you want to be successful. So I was able to do that for about 20 years. So the question I get asked a lot now is, why did you decide to become a librarian? Well, I knew that I still wanted to have a career where I could help people. And after I had my daughter, I realized that I couldn't work around the clock like I used to anymore. But interestingly, I discovered that I could approach librarianship with the same creativity and passion that I had used to develop and produce television shows. I still deliver information, but instead of in a newscast, I do it in emails, in classrooms, and at the reference desk. I still am part of the team, but instead of writers and producers and reporters, the team is comprised of other librarians and circulation staff. Sometimes my team is comprised entirely of teens like you. What I'm trying to do as your young adult librarian is to help you get to the next stage, just like I did with my daughter, who is now 19 and a second year student at the University of Chicago. I really understand where you are in your journey, and I want to help you get launched. Not just now, but for the rest of your life. The library has so many resources that you can possibly imagine. What you know about the library is just the very tip of the iceberg. Whatever you decide to study or learn, we have millions of resources that you can borrow or access for free. Books, audiobooks, movies, music, magazines, manga, databases, free online tutors, free practice tests, and programs that can enrich and enhance your life. As a former broadcast journalist and as a librarian today, I still believe that information can change your life. Almost every day, I deliver information to you teens about exciting and innovative opportunities like scholarships, how to visit colleges for free, internships like the one John did and missed the deadline on. I had to pull some strings to get him into that one. And I'll do that for you. Anyway, you should really get on my email distribution list so that you can find out about these opportunities. And I invite you to partner with me at the library to help me create these programs, because I really want to produce relevant programming that's going to help you. You can do that by doing your community service at the library, either as an intern or as a blogger. So the library's teen council meets every first Saturday of the month at 4 o'clock. And right now, we're looking for contributors to the blog that they just created. It's called the Pally Nook. I love that name. And you don't have to have prior experience We will train you, but working on this blog will give you a platform to express yourself and to articulate your unique point of view. And guess what? That's exactly what you're gonna have to do when you write your college essays. So, please come to the library. I really wanna make a connection with each of you. I really wanna find out what's on your bucket list, and hopefully, the library will help you to start ticking off those boxes. Thank you.